This is the first video of a series of video tutorials to learn how to use leather strips. On screen you can see some of the leather strips that I have recently bought on the internet. I usually use AliExpress for these orders. I'll talk about it later. Now you can see, for example, a leather strip of 1 meter length in warm white color. And now you will see other kind of leather strips, for example this one of 5 meters length. Some strips have a connector. As you can see, I'm using a typical battery connector. In other cases, I connect the strip with crocodile clips, like this one you see right now, that I'm connecting on the screen. Anyway, all these strips run always on 12 volts. We will talk later about transformers and the powers of the strips. Here we have another example of a leather strip. You can see that since it has no connector, if you don't want to use crocodile clips, you can use a connector that you can buy very cheap on the internet, for about 30 cents of dollar. That is the connector you see now on the screen. I will talk about these connectors in my second video, and also about the accessories to connect the strips without soldering. Let's now try a new leather strip. This one is also 5 meters length, and it's a strip of a standard white color, not warm white, as you can see on the screen. So, as you can imagine, these strips can be used in several projects, at home, at work, in your car or van, etc. To identify a strip of LEDs, what we have to do is to measure the LED. The LED measures in millimeters will give the name to the strip. The 3528 leather strip, as you can see, measures 3.5 millimeters by 2.8 millimeters. In the case of the 5050 leather strip, the LEDs are larger, and they measure 5 by 5 millimeters. You can see that the 5050 type consumes more and also gives more light than the 3528 leather strip. In addition, the strips also differ in the number of LEDs they have in each meter. If we count the LEDs there are, for example, in 10 centimeters of a strip, we can identify what type of a strip it is and its power or consumption. Look, here in 10 centimeters we can count 6 LEDs. Therefore, in a meter, there will be 60 LEDs. For that reason, this is a strip of 60 LEDs per meter. That implies that it will have a consumption per meter, according to what we see in this board, of 4.8 watts. That means 4.8 watts of power per meter, and since we supply 12 volts, the intensity associated to this consumption is going to be 0.4 amps or 400 milliamps per meter. This information is important to choose the transformer we need, since it must give enough power to the leather strip. Also in the board, we can see the brightness comparison between strips. Okay, they have the board on the screen. You can see the first column with the type of strip, the second column with the number of LEDs per meter, and in the third column you can find the power in watts per meter. Then, the fourth and fifth columns show the intensities in amps or milliamps. To finish, you can find the last column showing the luminosity per meter. With this board, you can compare the leather strips features. Regarding the purchase, I use AliExpress. There you have a couple of purchases of leather strips of 1 meter length that cost around a dollar or even less. And now you can see a 5 meter leather strip and the adapter I was talking about. They are 3528 leather strips, and they are all single color strips. But there are also multicolor leather strips on the market. As you can see, they have 4 contacts, the positive and the 3 channels, blue, red, green. And in this case, you can see a RGB strip of 5 meters length, which costs around $4. This is one of the purchases that I have made. More differences. There are strips resistant to water and strips that are not, depending on if they are covered with a rubber layer. If you buy them, check if it indicates that they are IP65, like this one that you see right now on the screen, or if they are not, like IP20, which is the one you see right now. The IP grade is used to classify them. The first number tells you what is the protection against solid bodies. A 6 means that it's fully protected against dust, and the second number is the water resistance. In this case, an IP65 waterproof strip resists the projection of water from all directions. Okay, we already know the type of strips and how to identify them, their power consumption, luminosity, etc. Regarding their connection, look, There I am indicating where to cut the LED strip. It is clearly marked on the strip. We could cut it there, and later we could tie the strip with another strip, or let it as the end of our strip. But we will talk about that in the next tutorial, where we will see how to join strips with different shapes, not only in lines, but in the shape of a T, etc., and how to connect them without soldering. You could also weld those terminals, positive with positive and negative with negative.